A unique cycling experience in Montreal is the Gilles Villeneuve racetrack, named after a celebrated race car driver from Quebec. This 4.3-kilometer-long Formula One track is located on Parc Jean-Drapeau, and when it's not being used for races, it's open to the public as a multi-use track. Biking here from downtown takes about 30 minutes, or you can take the metro to Jean-Drapeau station and get a Bixi bike at one of the stations here if you prefer. Depending on your speed, you can probably expect one lap to take between 7 and 15 minutes.
Cyclists are the biggest users of the track, although you also see people on skates, runners, and even some cars, which are allowed in a separate lane to the right. While some of them seem to be just there for the experience or novelty of driving on a racetrack, driving on the track is also necessary to access a parking lot for the beach.
On this track, you'll find a really big variation in cycling speeds. As you'd expect, this is one place in the city that's really well suited to the kind of cyclist that enjoys pushing their speed. But there are also lots of people going more casual speeds and everything in between. There's generally pretty good coexistence between cyclists going at different speeds, but it's not perfect.
There was a time that I wanted to pull off to the grass on the left side, so I did a shoulder check, gave a clear arm signal, and pulled over to the left, only to hear someone comment to their cycling group that people are so unpredictable. I picked the left to pull off to because cars use the right lane, but with the left being basically a cyclist highway, you have to use even more caution than you think. Don't let any of this discourage you from using the track, though. Be careful and aware of your surroundings. Stick to the left for passing if possible and the right for lower speeds, and everything should be fine.
We've been through this racetrack before on other trips, like the Petite Voie de Fleuve, but it's also a fun destination in its own right that we highly recommend for the cycling experience. You can bike at whatever speed you want, aside from a handful of pedestrian crossings to watch for, and you don't have to worry about cars like you would in the city. As we mentioned, you do see cars on the track sometimes, but they have their own lane and they tend to go pretty slow anyway, so they don't seem to cause any problems.
In addition to the track, there are also a few large and flat pavement areas where the spectator stands would normally be, which are pretty good for people learning how to skateboard or figuring out roller skis. This island also houses the Jean Doré Beach, the Montreal Casino, various gardens and pavilions, and the Olympic Basin for rowing. It's kind of like a big playpen for grown-ups.
Thanks for watching! That's it for our commentary, but the sped up video of one lap of the track will continue. As always, don't forget to bike and subscribe.